able to carry the banner of Islam on their shoulders. Because each one of them said, it is I who is responsible for Islam. Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anhu, he gathered the Sahaba in the Masjid, Masjid al-Nabi, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَقَالَ تَمَنَّوْا. He said, each one of you, tell me your wish. What would you like? تَمَنَّوْا. And Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, he said, يَا أَمِيرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَتَمَنَّا الضَّرْبُ بِالسَّيْفِ وَالصَّوْمُ بِالصَّيْفِ وَإِكْرَامُ الضَّيْفِ. He said, I wish for three things, يَا أَمِيرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. I wish for three things. الضَّرْبُ بِالسَّيْفِ, to go up فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, وَالصَّوْمُ بِالصَّيْفِ, and to fast during the hot summer days. وَإِكْرَامُ الضَّيْفِ, and to honor my guests. I have three wishes, O Amir al-Mu'mineen. Then Khalid bin Walid, he said, it's my turn, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen. أَتَمَنَّ, he said, I wish, if the night was cold and dark, and I cannot see my enemy, and I fight في سبيل الله until I die. Then Umar bin Khattab, when the other Sahaba, each one of them stated their wish, Umar bin Khattab, he said, وَأَنَا أَتَمَنَّ, I wish if this masjid was filled with men like Abu Ubaidah bin Jarrah. I wish فَأَسْتَخْدِمُهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, so I can use them to run the affairs of the Ummah. The Sahaba of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ali bin Abi Talib, two of his wish was for the sake of the Ummah. Khalid bin Walid, all his wish was for Sabilillah. Umar bin Khattab, his wish was for the Ummah. But if you were there, if I was there, and someone says, what is your wish? I would say, I wish if I were rich. If I was rich, I wish to have degrees so I can be, you know, well known. I wish if I was a successful businessman. I wish that many children, many sons and daughters. I wish, and I would wish it would be us in my that little bubble. But the Sahaba radiallahu anhu wished for the well-being of the Sahaba, of the deen. When كما في الأثر وفي غيره, when Surah Al-Hujurat was revealed, and Allah said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَرْفَعُوا أَصْوَاتَكُمْ فَوْقَ صَوْتِ النَّبِيِّ, or will you believe, do not raise your voice over the voice of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Qais bin Thabit, Thabit bin Qais, I'm sorry, he disappeared from the masjid. And after 3 days was from the sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to ask about the companions. قَالَ أَيْنَهُ, where is he? One of the Ansar, he said, يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, I will get him for you. So he went to his house. And then he said, مَا بِكْ, قَالَ هَلِتْ, I'm destroyed. He said, what did you do? He said, أَمَا تَعْلَمْ, don't you know? I have a very loud voice, and I've been raising my voice over the voice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And my amal is doomed. And then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the man came back to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he told the man, go and tell him that you're not amongst the people that a'mal are rendered. So he came back with him, and then he said, no, but anta min ahlil jannah, you are from the people of Jannah. When the Messenger of Allah passed away, listen to this, ya ikhwati illah. When the Messenger of Allah passed away, and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu became Khalifa, and the Arab, majority of the Arab, except people of Makkah, people of Medina, people of Taif, majority of the Arab, they rejected Islam. And they said, we used to believe and follow this man, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and now he's dead. We're not gonna give zakat. And Abu Bakr as-Siddiq qala wallahi law mana'uni 'iqalan kanu yadfa'una li rasulillah la qatantahum. And he said, wallahi, if they stop giving a rope that they used to give to the messenger of Allah, wallahi, I will fight them for it. And then the Sahaba رضي Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم went to where Musaylimah al-Kadhdhab was. And then they were attacked. And the Sahaba at the first, they ran away. And Qais bin Thabit رضي الله عنه, he said, he went to his tent. Read his biography. He went to his tent and he made it to the ghusl of janazah. And then he came back to the people who were running away. فَقَالَ يَا مَعْشَرَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ مَا هَكَذَا نُقَاتِلُ مَعَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. He said, not this. This is the way that we used to fight with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. We were men. We were not weak people. And then he went. And he got Salim, Mawla Aba Hudayfa. And he said, لَا يَأْتِيَنَّ الْعَدُوُّ مِنْ قِبَلِكُمْ. He said, do not allow the enemy to come from your side. فَقَالَ سَالِمْ بِعْسَ حَمِنْ لِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ إِنْ فَرَقْتُ الْيَوْمَ. He said, what a loser am I. What kind of loser am I if I run today while I'm the حَمِنْ لِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ. So they stood in front of the enemy. Some of the narration, they buried half of their bodies so they won't run when the enemies were coming towards them. And both of them were killed, radiallahu anhum ajma'in. But look how he approached the situation. He said, "Not this. This is not how we used to defend Islam. This is not our lifestyle. Our lives were for the Islam, fi sabilillah. And that is what is missing today, ya ikhwati fillah. Everyone else is living for him or herself, not for the deen of Islam, ya ikhwati fillah. Not for the deen of Islam. Even when they used to learn, they used to learn for the deen of Islam. Uqbah ibn Amr, when he accepted Islam, he came to the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he gave him the bay'ah. He decided to go back to his sheep because he was a shepherd. And he used to say, and 12 of them, the ru'a, 12 of them, we used to keep sheep together. And then they decided to say, subhanAllah, We gave a bay'ah to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but we're not learning anything from our deen. So they were smart. And they said, why don't we rotate? Each day one of us would go and learn from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Each day one of us will go and learn from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Uqbah, he said, I love my sheep. So I said to them, no, you go first. So every day one of them would go, listen to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, come back, and then teach the rest. He said, Uqba, I said to myself, what a loser, what kind of loser am I? Each one is learning from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I'm sitting here every day waiting a third person to tell me what the Messenger of Allah did. So he said, I said to my companions, you take care of the sheep. I no longer desire being part of this. And he took himself, went to the Masjid al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, became Sahib Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Rasulullah is teaching, he learns from him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Rasulullah is going to somewhere else, he will go with him until he became Qari li Kitabillah. And he had such a beautiful voice. Such a beautiful voice. Even after the death of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Umar bin Khattab used to come and he used to say to him, Ya Uqbah, remind us of Allah. Read from the book of Allah. And then he used to sit, radiallahu anhu, Amir al-Mu'mineen, and Uqbah would be reciting Quran to him, and Amir al-Mu'mineen, tears would be rolling from his eyes. And he will say, Jazakallah khayra, for reminding us the days of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Until Uqba bin Amr